दिस इज गेट 2022 लाइफ साइंसेस सेक्शन एस बायोकेमिस्ट्री क्वेश्चन नंबर 43. द स्टैंडर्ड फ्री एनर्जी चेंजेस फॉर कन्वर्जन ऑफ फॉस्फोइनॉल पाइरुवेट पीईपी टू पाइरुवेट एंड एटीपी सिंथेसिस आर शोन बिलो. सो ओके व्हाट वी हैव हियर, वी हैव पीईपी प्लस H2O gives you pyruvate and inorganic phosphate, okay? And then we have on the next reaction we have ADP-PI gives us ATP and H2O. Okay, so what is happening here? We have PEP conversion to pyruvate with very negative delta G, right? The delta G is very negative. So very negative delta G, what it means? Yeah, very highly spontaneous reaction, okay? Highly spontaneous reaction, the steps occur in glycolysis, right? This step occurs in the glycolysis, right? Last step of the glycolysis, PEP to pyruvate. Yeah, so this is highly spontaneous reaction. So what cell does it? So this energy which is released in delta standard free energy, okay, standard free energy is -61.9 kilojoule mole inverse. This is very high. So what cell does it? It uses or utilizes this energy to formation of ATP. Okay, so the Gibbs free energy for ATP synthesis is 30.5. So what it is doing is this process of clubbing the formation of ATP to very high negative delta G reaction. This process is known as substrate level. So this process is known as substrate level phosphorylation, in which the formation of ATP is clubbed to highly negative delta G, the reactions which have highly negative delta G, okay? So if we add this reaction, okay, if we add this reaction, the resultant reaction will be this. How did we get this? So if we add this reaction, what we'll get? We just add this reaction, what we'll get? These terms will get cancelled, the H2O will get cancelled, right? So we'll left with PEP plus ADP, right? This is the resultant reaction, PEP plus ADP giving us pyruvate plus ATP, okay? And what will be the resultant free energy change? Yes, what it will be? We have to just add this also. If we add this, how much it will be? It will be -31.4. So the overall delta G, it's still negative, right? What it means? It is still feasible. That's why it's still feasible, and it is feasible, and it occurs in the cell at 37 degrees Celsius, right? At 37 degrees Celsius. So because of this high negative delta G, we are able to use it for the utilization of ATP, okay? And they have given us the starting concentration of PEP, ADP, pyruvate and ATP to be 25, 25, 50, 50 millimolar respectively. They have given us R, which is equal to 8.315 joule mole inverse Kelvin inverse. The actual free energy change in kilojoule mole inverse for this reaction is dash. Okay, so there are so many values here. First, it is very important to check all the units. So we have this delta G in kilojoule, kilojoule mole inverse, and we need the answer in kilojoule mole inverse, and the R, the gas constant value, is in joule mole inverse. Okay, this is very important. If you as it is take this value and not convert it into kilojoule, you'll get a wrong answer here, okay? This is very important that we have to convert the universal gas constant R to kilojoule, just multiplied by 10 to power 3, right? from joule to kilojoule, we have to multiply it by 10 to power minus 3, right? If you are going from joule to kilojoule, right, we have to multiply by 10 to power minus 3. Yeah, very simple. So we already know the resultant Gibbs free energy. We need to calculate the actual free energy change. Okay, so we know the Gibbs free energy. We need to calculate the actual free energy change and the the formula is very, equation is very simple. The Gibbs free energy change, delta G is equal to delta G naught, right, delta G naught plus RT ln Q, right? Very simple. Everybody remembers this from the previous lectures also. Delta G, Gibbs free energy, actual Gibbs free energy change is delta G naught. Delta G naught is what? What is delta G naught? Standard Gibbs free energy, right? Everybody remember this. Delta G naught is a standard Gibbs free energy. Standard Gibbs free energy at standard temperature pressure conditions. So, which is pH 7, 25 degrees Celsius at 1 molar. These are the standard temperature pressure condition. Okay. And this, the delta G at Gibbs free energy at standard Gibbs free energy calculated at this STPs is this, what we calculated resultant, which is minus 31.4. Okay. And we need to calculate the actual free energy change. Okay. And reaction quotient. This is also very simple. What is reaction quotient? Reaction quotient, product of pyruvate. What are the products here? Pyruvate and ATP are the products, upon product of reactants, which is PP and ADP. Very simple. This is very simple problem. There are too many values and terms, but this is very simple problem. We just need to calculate Q by from these values. Okay, they have given a starting concentration also, very simple, and we need to calculate delta G. Okay, let's find out delta G then. The initial concentration of PEP is 25, ADP is 25. I'll write the reaction PEP to PEP plus ADP will give us pyruvate, right? Last step of glycolysis plus ATP, will get ATP synthesis also. And finally, pyruvate is 50-50. Pyruvate is 50 and ATP is also 50. Okay, we'll find out reaction quotient from here. Okay, so let's start with reaction quotient. We'll solve one by one. So reaction quotient is product upon reactant. So 50 upon 50. So these are 50, 25 upon 25. So this will become 5 5s are 25 25 is square 625. This is 4, right? Q is 4. Delta G is equal to delta G naught, right, plus RT ln Q. Okay, Q we already know 4, so we need to calculate delta G. Delta G naught is minus 31.4, right? Minus 31.4, right? The resultant Gibbs free energy standard गैस कांस्टेंट इज 8.315, रिमेंबर टू मल्टीप्लाई बाय 10^-3, ओके, बिकॉज इट वॉज इन जूल, वी नीड एवरीथिंग इन किलो जूल, सो द फाइनल डेल्टा जी विल ऑलवेज विल ऑल्सो बी इन किलो जूल. And temperature was 37 degree Celsius. So we have to convert it into Kelvin, right? So Kelvin 37 will be 37+273, which is 310, right? Into 310 into ln 4. Okay. So this will become -31.4. 8.315 into 310. This will be around 2.57 into ln 4 is how much? Natural log of 4. Natural log of 4 is 1.38. So -31.4 plus this multiplication will give us 3.52 -31.4 will get -27.8 kilojoule mole inverse, right? Delta G is equal to -27.8 kilojoule mole inverse. So the rounded off to one decimal place, so this we can write this as we can round it off to 9. Okay, you have to be very careful, like what are they asking? Actual free energy. They could ask you standard free energy change. They could, okay, so it is, these terms are very important. You have to know, this is the standard Gibbs free energy, the naught, delta G naught. Okay, delta G naught is standard Gibbs free energy of this reaction. This is standard Gibbs free energy of this reaction. So the resultant standard Gibbs free energy of this reaction will be -61.9+30. Okay, which we got 31.4. So this is very important for us to recognize what is given and what we have to find out. We need to find out actual Gibbs free energy. Okay. And the next important thing is the units. So here the units are in kilojoules and it is in the joule. So it is very important to check the units, okay, multiple times, because there are no options in this question. So it is very so you can make mistakes easily. So please check units of all the terms, and also check how much it is also important, if they are asking you to round it off, please round it off to only single decimal. Okay.